Okay, so light reaction, okay? We have covered 9.1 until 9.3. Now we're going to continue from 9.4 until 9.9. I do not know, maybe we'll only finish up to 9.5. Let's see. Number one, what you need to understand is the organization of photosynthetic apparatus. This is very important. This is the basic of photosynthesis. You need to understand photosynthesis is not happening in just about anywhere. It is happening in a specific location inside a cell. Okay? And inside a cell, there are many organelles, meaning that membrane-bound structure. Okay? Subcellular compartment of a cell. Okay? And there are many. There are nucleus, there are vacuoles, there are mitochondria, and so on. We are interested with a type of plastid. Okay, so there is a group of organelles. Collectively, it's called plastid. One type of plastid that we are interested today, which is the chloroplast, okay, which is this guy. So this is a cross-section from electron microscope. You can see that chloroplast, why is it not green? This is electron microscope, no color. Okay. Actually, the reason you see the color green for the chloroplast is because you are dealing with visible light. When the sample is in the microscope, people are not using visible light anymore. They use argon gas. So, no color. But they give off the charges and signal so that the computer can interpret, you get this image. Right. There are important structures that you need to understand here. This is a look a bit boring, right? Let's use the cartoon part of it. So in the plant cell, you got this plant cell, see? Many blobs. And then we are interested with these green blobs here. Okay? Enlarge this and then you get this. Number one, chloroplast double membrane. Please remember that. It's got the outer membrane and inner membrane that enveloped the entire thing, okay? And in between the membrane, there is an intermembrane space. And this is very important because not all substance can go in and out into the chloroplast. It's kind of highly regulated, okay? And it's also important because this is where the plants will eventually decide to have more sugar transported out of the cells or otherwise. Okay, so inside the chloroplast now, you can see the stacking of pancake here, the green pancake here. Yeah, so we focus in here, we enlarge this here. I know that maybe you have learned this before, the concept of grana, granum, that kind of thing. But this time we're going to correct your understanding with the correct labeling, okay? So, a stack of this thing is called granum. One pancake, two pancake, three, four, five, six. The whole thing is called granum, okay? One pancake is called a thylakoid disc. It's not written this there, but it's called this. It's actually a disc, okay? And this kind of granum, when you go deeper in learning photosynthesis, it's actually called as either grana lamellae or stroma lamellae, meaning that depending on the location and the shape of this structure, it will determine later what kind of biochemical process happens to it. Look at here. This collectively, you call it grana lamellae, right? Remember, grana lamellae, stack of thylakoid. This is where the photosystem is located. You will learn later that in order to capture and bless the light, plants have two important photosystems. Photosystem to do what? Capture and utilize. OK? Okay, so the first one of the photosystem is located primarily in this grana lamellae. And what about these connecting bridges here? This is called the stroma lamellae. Okay, it is not part of the pancake, but it's rather protruding out of the structure. Okay, look at this. This is actually not individual disc, even though I called this just now. It's actually like your intestine. Your intestine is a long tube, right? 6 meters or more. So that tube is arranged in such a way. Does it look like your intestine? So this tube, when it is arranged upon on top of each other in that folding manner, it gives the illusion of pancake stacking, but it's actually a one long tube like your intestine. Okay, right. So what other thing is important? The stroma. What is the stroma? The stroma is the environment inside the chloroplast, the soup inside the chloroplast. If the soup in the cell we call cytoplasm, the soup in the chloroplast we call stroma. Okay, not stoma. Stoma are the microscopic pores on the leaf surface. That's not it. This is stroma. Okay, right. Yeah, get it? I do expect for you to be able to draw this. Okay. So I do not know, this is the time, if you don't like drawing, this is the time to like it a bit, right? Okay.